My poor Japp, I'm afraid your presentation of the case revolts the intelligence.
It doesn't revolt mine. Well, I've got to get back to her flat. I've got a few more questions for her ladyship now.
Hastings and I will accompany you.
I don't want you to.
It's on our way.
I don't...
Resign yourself to the fact that from now on, everywhere you go is on our way.
Damned if Lady Edgware wasn't where she said she was. The other guests swear she never left the table. Well, only to take a phone call, and even then she was never out of the butler's sight. Early? I've been up for hours, on business, murder.
And who, pray, has been murdered?
Lord Edgware, stabbed to death last night by his wife. She's Jane Wilkinson, the American actress.
Well, what makes you think?
Think? I know. She arrived last night around 10 in a blinking cab, announced herself to the butler like she was dropping in for tea, and this morning, there was his lordship, with a neat little hole straight through the cistern, into the medulla.
Well, why should she do a thing like that?
Wanted to marry another bloke. And she actually said she meant to call round in a cab and waste him. I'm also informed that you met Lord Edgware yesterday. You'd like to tell me about that? I've seen her, but she won't say a word without a solicitor. Until he shows up, my men are staying right on top of her. In a manner of speaking. Poirot, buzz off like a good chap, will you? I've got bigger fish to fry.
In a good bouillabaisse, the little fish...
What's fish got to do with it?
It was your own metaphor.
What do you mean?
I didn't bring the fish.
I didn't either.
Oh, stop fish, then. Let's leave it out. Listen to me.
By Jove, you're right.
And that's not all.
Poirot, you've done it again. I'll have her picked up immediately.
Oh, she's been picked up already, my friend. She's dead.
Yeah, yeah. That's right, she is. Well, I don't know, do I? I'm hearing this for the first time. She kills him... Perhaps by accident, impulsively. Then overcome by guilt or fear, she takes a drug overdose.
It makes sense, Poirot.
Oh, great minds think alike.
I withdraw my comment.
All right, come on, come on. It's a better angle than the butler did it. And the rest are all accounted for. Look, the nephew was at the opera, the daughter was at the opera, the wife was at the dinner, right?
Yeah, accident. She came home all excited, took some Veronal to calm down, some more to go to sleep, and...
Then some more Veronal, and a little more, and...
Well, Mr. Marsh is going to miss all this, isn't he?
Oh, you'll have to release him tomorrow, Japp, you know that.
Oh, yeah?
We know of your whereabouts on the evening in question.
I didn't go to my uncle's to kill him.
Well, why did you? And who was the woman with him?
I'd rather not say.
Well, I'll ask you again. What was the reason for your visit?
Money. What else? Of course, I trotted over to investigate.
Well, that's all very well thought out, I must say. But you couldn't have seen Brian Martin that evening. He was having dinner with Jenny Driver, the designer.
Was he?
Yes, well, you're not the only one with interesting little tidbits, Poirot. And you've neglected to mention the £10,000 you offered Carlotta Adams.
Oh, we're still playing a little innocent on that one, are we?
I don't know what you mean. Where would I get £10,000? I was flat broke until my uncle's murder.
For which you are under arrest. Read him his rights and take him away.
No!
Satisfied now, Poirot?
But we've got the murderer locked up, so why waste everybody's time?
No, bear with me for a moment.
Poirot, please, before I grow old, retire and move to Brighton. Who is it?
Bear with me, and I will reveal to you where was I.
I don't know how you do it.
I think you better come with me, miss.
Where are you going?
Going with you.
You don't know where I'm going.
Where are you going?
To Lord Edgware's house.
Ah, it's on our way. Come on.
I don't think that Scotland Yard guy likes me.
Oh, he's just trying to do his duty.